So at this point, I'm sure most of us are ready for the worldwide celebration to officially come to an end. I mean, overall, it was just a very disappointing major celebration. And I know that might sound a little bit harsh, but honestly, for something that only happens once per year, I just feel like they could have done a much better job with it, you know, at least from a content perspective, right? Like, don't get me wrong, I think the new units are absolutely amazing, right? The Vegito, the Boo Tanks, the Angel Vegeta, even the side units, the Tien and Chiaotzu, Tien and Piccolo, they're all awesome units. I love them, but as I always say, good units don't make for good celebrations when the content is lacking. And in this case, for this celebration, the content was definitely lacking, and there were just too many dead periods with nothing to do. So for that reason, I do think it was definitely a disappointment, but of course, that's just my personal opinion. You guys can totally feel free to disagree with me. And you know what? I'll save the rest of my thoughts and feelings for a separate video because I could go on for a while. But on the bright side, the end is near. We're only about a week away from another celebration coming, another campaign coming, and we should see a new banner dropping on the global side of the game on October 4th or around that time. So the question that a lot of people have been asking me over the past couple of days or even weeks is what this banner is going to be and what the new units are going to be, right? So in today's video, we're going to talk about that. But before we jump in, I do want to give a quick shout out to a sponsor of the channel, which is Modera Accounts. They're a highly trusted seller for stacked Dokkan accounts with thousands of stones as well as many top tier units. If you guys are looking to pick up a new account, either to start the game over or just to do some summons for fun, then feel free to check out their website in my description down below. And if you guys find something you like, you can use my code TIGER for 20% off your entire purchase. Okay, so with that said, let's quickly take a look at all of the banners from JP that we're currently still missing on Global. And if we go in chronological order, then the next two banners we should be getting is actually the Boo and Gotenks Dual Dokkan Fest. But of course, that's not how things always work, right? So since we're coming off a major Dual Dokkan Fest in this celebration, the worldwide celebration, it's very unlikely that we're going to be getting a Dual Dokkan Fest right after. So these banners are most likely going to be pushed to November, I would say, like early to mid-November. And from there, we also have the Waifu Double Rates banner with the awakenings for these girls. And I think she also got an awakening during this time. But anyways, this Double Rates Rising Dragon Carnival banner, we should also be getting, but I don't think it's going to be after the worldwide celebration. And then there's still the LR Blue Boys banner, which of course a lot of people are very excited for, and rightfully so because they are amazing units. But I expect this banner to drop sometime around the end of November / beginning of December, along with the Tanabata banner, which will feature the first return of the LR Blue Fusions. So for anybody that missed them the first time around, during the anniversary, it will become available for purchase in the Baba Shop, which is pretty exciting. And after that, we should be getting the LR Jiren banner. So yeah, these guys will be at the end of the year and won't be after the worldwide celebration. So that being said, the banner that I do think will be dropping on Global at the beginning of October after this celebration is over is the Tech Transforming Gohan banner, which for me is pretty damn exciting because this dude, in my opinion, is currently the best TUR in the entire game. Okay, and of course there is some debate about that. Some people still think it's cooler, some people think it's Vegito Blue, some people think it's somebody else, maybe Bardock or something like that, but for the most part, I think most people, or a good proportion of people, agree with me that Ultimate Gohan is one of, if not the best, TUR in the game right now. And here is a quick look at the banner. So there was a new Supreme Kai that fuses into Kabuto Kai through an active skill, or no. No, it is an active skill. Yeah, through an active skill. And we also, of course, have the Gohan himself, who can transform into Ultimate Gohan. And we have AGL Bardock, who might be replaced because we did recently have him featured on the Vegito banner. Or was it Boo banner? I forgot. But either way, he was recently featured. But I also feel like there's a good chance they just keep him there. And now we have Piccolo, we have Kid Goku, Metal Cooler, as well as the STR Ultimate Gohan, who obviously is not the most exciting inclusion, but of course it just makes sense for him to be here. So that is the banner, and overall I think it's a pretty solid banner. Definitely not the best Dokkan Fest banner we've ever seen, but not the worst either. I would give it like a 7.5 out of 10 in terms of value. And for Gohan himself alone, I think that while it's not a must summon, it's a you should definitely consider summoning because he is that good. And for anybody that has no idea what he does, let's check him out. Okay, so we're gonna pop over to the Dokkan Wiki here. And his leader skill is, of course, two categories, Saviors, which is a new category, or Hybrid Saiyans, Ki plus 3, HP plus 130%, and Attack and Defense plus 170%. His super attack is crazy because it greatly raises attack and defense infinitely, right? So 50% every single time for up to 99 turns. That's crazy. His attack and defense stacks so damn fast when you're doing LGE or Infinite Dragon Ball History or any of the longer events in the game. He also causes immense damage, of course, pretty standard. And his passive is attack and defense plus 140%. Pretty huge boost already. Guards all attacks, and then Ki plus 1 at the start of each turn, up to Ki plus 3, plus an additional attack plus 40% within the same turn when guard is activated. And since this 40% is calculated separately, the total boost is actually 236% attack after being attacked, which is massive, right? And he also has the active skill, which unlocks potential and grows stronger, can be activated starting from the fifth turn from start of battle, and this essentially transforms him into Ultimate Gohan. His links are Brainiacs, All in the Family, Saiyan Lineage, Cold Judgment, Revival, Power Bestowed by God, and Fierce Battle. So in terms of links, there are a few issues because, of course, there's not a lot of ki here, but he does give himself up to 3 ki, so that does solve most of his ki issues, and I don't think it's a huge issue, but of course some people might not like that. And his categories are Hybrid Saiyans, Resurrected Warriors, Majin Buu Saga, Goku's Family, Siblings Bond, Revenge, Rapid Growth, and Saviors. And then once you transform into Ultimate Gohan, his super attack greatly raises attack for one turn, causes immense damage with a medium chance of stunning the enemy, and his passive is Ki plus 3, attack and defense plus 158%, and guards all attacks plus an additional attack plus 58% for the rest of the battle when guard is activated. Attacks effective against all types when facing only one enemy whose HP is 58% or more, or when facing a Majin Buu Saga category enemy. So once again, 58% is calculated separately here. So after being attacked, his total attack boost is 307.64%, along with the attacks effective against all. He's guarding all attacks, so he's tanking really, really well. He's also already gonna have a ton of defense because you've been stacking in this form. So yeah, he's just a overall monster, both offensively and defensively, man. He does it all. He puts up huge numbers when attacking and takes very, you know, small numbers when defending. I just love this unit. I am definitely going deep, going hard for this guy, and I just can't wait. And hopefully he is the next banner on Global. Of course, I don't know for sure. This is a bit of speculation, but it's very, very likely gonna be him on Global next at the beginning of October. Okay, so that is the Ultimate Gohan. He does get three new links, Infighter, Saiyan Warrior Race, and Shocking Speed. This should help with some of the ki issues, but once again, he actually gives himself ki, so I don't really see it being a big issue anyways. Now, before we go, let's take a quick look at the Supreme Kai and Kibito as well. And their leader skill is Batara category Ki plus 4, HP attack and defense plus 100%. Super attack greatly raises defense for one turn, causes supreme damage with a high chance of stunning the enemy. And the passive is Ki plus 2, attack and defense plus 120%. Attack enemies, attack and defense minus 30% for 2 turns. High chance of evading enemies' attack, including super attack, and recovers 10% HP at the end of the turn. Active skill, performs Batara Fusion, can be activated upon entering attacking turn. So essentially, you can pop this anytime you want, but there is a benefit to not fusing because you do have that high chance of evading enemies' attack. So in terms of defense, you're probably better off keeping them in this form, but once you fuse into Kibito Kai, your super attack becomes greatly raises attack and defense for one turn, causes supreme damage, and seals super attack. And passive is Ki plus 3, attack and defense plus 150%, all enemies attack and defense minus 20%, and stuns the attacked enemy for 2 turns. Once only, recovers 10% HP at the end of turn. Really good passive overall, but as you can see, no chance to dodge. So, like I said, I think if you're trying to be a little bit more defensive, then it's probably a better idea to keep them as Supreme Kai and Kibito. But I do really like the option of being able to, you know, pop that fusion anytime I want. So yeah, really good unit as well. Obviously not as impressive as the Gohan, but still a very good secondary unit that's coming with the banner. And that is today's video, guys. If you are wondering what the next unit and next banner on Global would be after this celebration ended, then here you go. It should be the Ultimate Gohan banner. I could be wrong. I just want to be clear about that. It's not 100%, but it's very, very likely. And if it is this guy's banner, then let me know in the comments down below how you guys feel about it. If you're excited to summon for him, or is it going to be a skip for you? And you'll save for something else, like the Jiren or Blue Boys or something like that. For me, as much as I want Jiren, as much as I want... Yo, what's going on here? Anyways, as much as I want the Blue Boys, the Jiren, and also, you know, I do want Gotenks and Buu as well. Honestly, Gohan is just my number one priority right now, and I don't really care about anybody else until I manage to pull him. Alright, so once again, that is the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And, you know, as always, if you liked the video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.